The United States will withdraw from the Paris Climate Accord.
China's resolve, aims, and policy moves in dealing with climate change will not change.
China, one of the top carbon emitters in the world, now is putting its words into action. The carbon emissions trading system has been launched, which means companies can trade their carbon emissions quotas just like commodities.
For those companies whose management is bad and have poor equipment, the more they produce, the higher the pressure they'll face, because they need to spend much more money on buying the carbon emission quotas.
Under the Paris Accord, China has promised to cut carbon emissions by 60 to 65% per unit of GDP by 2030 compared with 2005 levels. In the meantime, it would boost its use of non-fossil fuels, making them account for 20% of China's energy consumption. Shanghai is one of the pilot cities starting in 2013.
Now, the quantity of carbon emissions has decreased by 7% in recent years, and the use of coal went down by 11.7%.
Last week, the Chinese-led Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank approved a $250 million loan to connect some 220,000 rural Chinese households to a natural gas distribution network. But supplies are still set to be falling short of the surging demand.
When it comes to reducing carbon emissions, it's not always about what the governments can do. It's also about how ordinary people can contribute. A UN report says that the process of producing, transporting and packaging the food waste can generate more than 3 billion metric tons of carbon dioxide. And if this amount of food were a country, it would be the third largest emitter of greenhouse gases, just after the US and China. Li Jianhua, CGTN, Beijing.